In this video, I'm going to show you how to download and style data from OpenStreetMap. Let's first rearrange the screen a bit. If you work on a small laptop screen, it's easy to have the layers panel on top of the browser, so you see that it's in two different tabs now. And in the coordinate field, if I type there world, it will give me a world map. This is data from natural Earth. It comes here with QGIS. And I can zoom in on an area of interest. But of course I want it a bit more specific, so I can install a plugin, which is called the geocoding plugin. And with this plugin I can find addresses and place names. It uses the OpenStreetMap nominatim database and a Google database. So let's type Amman here, and it gives me all the results. I'll just choose one here and I end up there in Amman. But I need a bit more context, so I'm going to install another plugin, the Quick Map Services plugin. And that plugin will give me access to a lot of online maps that I can use as a backdrop. And I find it in the web menu, but it gives me just limited choices. If I now go to settings and then to more services, I can click on get contributed back. And then if I go back, I have a much longer list and I can see here the Bing satellite images, a lot of different choices, Google satellite, for example, and OpenStreetMap, that's the one we're going to use now. So I load the OSM standard, I can uncheck the world map, and now I have some context. And basically everything that you see on this backdrop on OpenStreetMap can be downloaded as vectors. So it's not just a picture. Well, it is a picture here in the Quick Map Services plugin, but all these features can be downloaded. Therefore, I'm going to install the QuickOSM plugin. And we're going to download some features. So QuickOSM uses the Overpass API, and it's an easy way to connect to the OpenStreetMap data and get it into QGIS. You can find it under the vector menu after installing the plugin. And here you can click on help with key value, because you need to specify keys and values, because the data is organized in key and values. And here you see all the keys and values that you can use with an indication if it's available as points, lines or polygons, and a description and a picture. But it's of course much easier if you do a search on the page. If you're looking, for example, for rivers, and you can find where it's mentioned on the page. And there we see waterway river, that is linear flow of a river in flow direction. That's the one that we need first if we want to download all the rivers. So here back in QuickOSM, I can specify as key waterway, as value river, and I specify where it has to look for it, and I want it in the canvas extent, so the area where we zoomed into. And I want it as lines, so I uncheck the other options. And then the timeout can be increased if you have a slow internet connection, but I keep it on default. And it downloaded the rivers. They're not very visible because we need to tweak a bit the styling, and it's only visible in a part of the area, as you can see when I switch off the OSM standard. So let's zoom to that area. We see there in a brown color the lines. We also see that it is a temporary layer, a scratch layer, which we can make permanent. You have to be careful with those, because you will lose it if you don't make it permanent. So they're only there temporarily. Later we are going to save all of them in a GeoPackage, so we don't bother with that now. We're going to style it. So I'm going to choose here a nice color. River should be blue. So now it's a nice blue river, and we can make it a bit thicker. And let's add some labels. So go to the label tab and change it to single labels. And here you see the international name. If we want a local name, I can choose the name field. And there we see it in Arabic. and go to the placement tab and I choose curved, so it's nicely curved along the river. And I can improve it a bit by using a text buffer. By default it's a white buffer, but we can also give the buffer a subtle color of the background. And we can click on color and then we can sample the background color of OpenStreetMap. There it is, and now you see that we get this nice effect with the buffer around the text. And we can also change the font and the font size and the color. So it would be nice to make this also blue. And change the size a bit. And depending on the font, you can also change if it's bold or italic. I'll put it on italic. Okay, let's download some other features from OpenStreetMap using QuickOSM. So let's download the lake and the dam here. So go to QuickOSM, choose waterway, dam, also in the canvas extent, and the dam, I want it as lines. There it is. You can see it, we downloaded the line. Let's also get the lake. We use as a key natural and then water. Also in the canvas. And the lake should be a polygon. And we also download the springs as points. And let's style these things. Let's first style the lake. I'm going to use a shape burst fill to get a very nice effect. So I go from a blue color, and not to white, but to another blue. Here it is, but it's not still what I want, so I'm going to change here the distance of the shading to 6 and change the blur strength. So now we get this nice effect with the deep and the shallow water. And it's also good to have a shoreline, so I add a new style layer and I use the simple line. And this one should be the same blue as the dark blue. Now we have a nice shoreline. Now I also want to give a label to the lake. Go again to single labels and use name, the local name. Let's change some settings. Change the color of the label. Black is not so nice. Let's make it white. And change the font to Calibri, bold italic. Change the placement to horizontal. And let's wrap it on a space so we have two words. And change the alignment to center. I also go to the rendering options there and check the box to only draw labels that fit completely in the feature and otherwise don't draw them. Now let's style the dam. Can increase the thickness of the line and I add another layer. And there I choose the marker line and I change the marker to a vertical line. And I change the stroke width to 0.2 and the size to 3. So we get this nice pattern for the dam. And we can also add a label. You can play with the settings until you get what you want. Change the distance from the line, but it's nicer if it's below the line and if it's centered, so this looks better. Finally, we're going to style the natural springs. I changed the simple marker to an SVG marker. SVGs are little vector pictures. And I go to symbol, and then I choose the blue marker. I'm going to change the size. There we go. So now all these springs are visible. So we have styled our springs, lakes, dam, and the river. So that makes already a nice map. And now the next step is to save this all in a GeoPackage so we can use it and share it also in other projects, and other people can also use it. And therefore we use the package layers tool from the processing toolbox, and we choose the layers that we want to store. That's only those from the OpenStreetMap. And I save it to a GeoPackage. Call it study area. So GeoPackage is a database, and in the database there will be the layers, and it will include the styling because we kept that box checked. And now it is stored. The layers are not loaded here, but I will load it in a new fresh project. So I'm going to remove everything that we have here. And I go to the place where I stored it, OpenStreetMap tutorial. There I find the GeoPackage, and I select the layers and I drag it to the map canvas, and they're loaded with the correct styling. So this is an easy way to provide layers and styling to other people by simply storing them in a GeoPackage, which is one file. Let's also add the OpenStreetMap back again. There it is, our final project. Now for the assignment, you can make a screenshot. You can use the snipping tool or any other tool. There's a link in the assignment where you can find other tools. And you need to make a screenshot of this window. And you can save this here as a PNG. And submit the file. So it's important that it includes the layer styling panel and the map, so I can judge it.